Jeff Dirk with We Are Change Connecticut. We're out here at the 2014 Liberty Forum, and we're here with one of the speakers and also did a screening of his documentary reality show, Sovereign Living. We're here with John Bush. John, thanks for coming out. Tell us about the documentary for those who might not know about it, and basically how you combine that into getting involved in doing sustainable living and much more.
Right on. The documentary reality show is called Sovereign Living. It's a reality-based program that follows my family and I in our quest to become self-sufficient and lead a voluntary and natural life. We're planning on having 12 episodes, and a lot of it has to do with self-sufficiency. There's an episode about natural health. We cover how to deal with neighbor problems without relying on the police. The show covers the home birth of our second child. In future episodes, we're going to get into community defense, how we can protect ourselves and defend ourselves without relying on the police. We're going to get into alternative education and all sorts of good stuff like that. Essentially, we're trying to put together a program that educates, entertains, and inspires people all in one package. And, you know, we want to kind of lead by example and show people that there's another way we can live that's not dependent on centralized or coercive institutions. So the show does just that. We're working with Kamikaze Productions to put together the program, and the quality is on par with television reality shows. So we're really proud of the work that they're doing, and we hope that not only can we encourage liberty people and people in the truth and patriot movements to step outside of the traditional way of thinking about how we can solve the problem of tyrannical government and coercive institutions. But on top of that, we want to reach out to the masses through this medium of a reality show, which seems to be pretty popular these days.
Just maybe a background on yourself, how you became involved in this, and basically your own transformation kind of from this documentary, and how you've kind of speak truth to power and live your own life based on what you've done in that documentary and also your rest of your family. Kind of get into that if you want.
Sure. In 2002, I came across a documentary on cable access down in Austin, Texas, called 9/11 Road to Tyranny by Alex Jones. A lot of We Are Change supporters are probably familiar with that show and definitely familiar with Alex Jones. And, it kind of blew my mind. I was always a bit of an anti-authoritarian type, but watching that documentary and, being exposed to an alternate view of what happened on September 11th really changed the way that I looked at the world. And from there, I went deep down the rabbit hole, researching the conspiratorial view of history and the idea that there's a cabal of individuals that are using government and corporations in order to manipulate history in their favor. And, from there I got involved with the American Civil Liberties Union and started a chapter at Texas State University. Started to appreciate the Constitution and the Founding Fathers, who later I would not appreciate the Founding Fathers or the Constitution. And then, long story short, the Ron Paul campaign came around in 2007. I was exposed to the philosophy of libertarianism. And from Ron Paul, I was exposed to Murray Rothbard and the philosophy of anarcho-capitalism, and really appreciated the consistency of anarchism over minarchism. In 2007, we founded a political action committee called Texans for Accountable Government, did a lot of work pushing back on the police state at the local and state level and the surveillance state. And then after that, I met my wife, now wife, Catherine Bleich, and both of us were focusing on fusion centers at the time, the Big Brother multi-jurisdictional law enforcement information gathering and intelligence sharing systems. And we went on a national tour visiting these fusion centers and reaching out to activist groups and teaching them about the dangers of the fusion center systems. That culminated with us being on an episode of Conspiracy Theory with Jesse Ventura, which was pretty cool. So we felt like we were pretty successful in getting the word out about fusion centers really early on in the understanding of that part of the police state, the Big Brother system. More recently, Catherine and I grew tired of politics. We did a lot of local and state activism, me in Austin, her in Kansas City, and while we had these victories, they were really empty victories, because every step we would take, well, it actually wasn't a step forward, it was preventing bigger steps from going backwards. But every little minor victory we had, it seemed like there would be thousands and thousands of losses of our liberty. So we decided that, if we really want to change the world and create a more free society, the best thing we can do is change the way we live. and try to live our lives in a manner that's more consistent with the philosophy of liberty. And since then, I've started a nonprofit called the Center for Natural Living. I've done radio shows here and there as well, like Rise Up Radio, and now I'm the editor and founder of the Liberty Beat. It's a daily news service that plays on the radio in Austin and other places. People can check it out at thelibertybeat.com. It was the Center for Natural Living, that's the nonprofit organization that's producing the Sovereign Living reality show. Along the way, we've had two kids, both natural home births, and we're trying to instill in our children a sense of sovereignty, and we're trying to lead them by example and not willingly submit to coercive institutions, and show them that, you know, through community we can build the ideal world that we all desire. And I think it's a strong message, and I'm excited to share it with as many people as possible and encourage people and inspire people to take responsibility for the situation that they're in, not to rely on politicians to vote a certain way or political parties to elect certain candidates. You know, if we really want to create freedom, it's up to us to find freedom in our own lifetime.
I think you touched upon that a little too, is that not getting past the point of not relying on politicians and start changing within yourself, and also being more sustainable and being more relying more on your food, you know, growing your own food, growing your own stuff. Maybe get into detail about how you transform to that, where you're starting on that path to basically not being dependent on the system of, you know, relying on, you know, with the food and the GMOs that's been going on, and changing that to, you know, better health and better food for everybody.
Yeah, I originally got into food production and self-sufficiency out of a fear that the economy was going to collapse, and I thought I need to become self-sufficient so I can continue to thrive even if the economy does collapse. But in learning more about growing your own food and eating healthier, I began to have an appreciation of that intrinsically. Regardless of what the economy's doing or if you can get groceries at the grocery store, I think it's better for us to grow our own food, to eat locally sourced foods, to avoid non-organic vegetables, and to avoid genetically modified organisms. So we're trying to encourage people and educate people a lot about that. There's a lot of people in the liberty movement that are focused on finding freedom from coercive government, but at the same time they're enslaved to their own health problems, and people feel lethargic and weighted down and have diseases that can be cured really if they simply change their diet and stop pumping themselves full of toxins and GMOs and fluoridated water and high fructose corn syrup, aspartame. So that's something that's covered in the fifth episode of Sovereign Living, and something that we focus on with the nonprofit, the Center for Natural Living, just encouraging people to realize that you really are what you eat. So if you eat crap, you're gonna feel like shit. It's pretty simple. I would encourage people to, you know, Catherine lost a lot of weight like 4 or 5 years ago. She didn't go on a diet. She just stopped eating non-organic food, and that's all it took. We recently did a month-long paleo diet, and totally changed the way that I feel. Then we dropped the paleo and went gluten-free, and then about a month ago I started eating gluten again, and I started feeling this strange congestion in my sinuses. So a lot of people think, oh, you know, I don't have any allergy to gluten. They just don't realize that their entire life they haven't felt perhaps in a way that they could truly feel, you know, feel much better. So I would recommend people start by eating as much organic, avoiding non-organic foods, cut high fructose corn syrup, cut sugar too. There's like 50 grams of sugar in a soda. That stuff jacks with your heart and your metabolism and all sorts of systems in your body. And try to avoid GMO foods. And a big step too is cutting gluten. And I think if people try that for like 2 weeks, they'll find that they feel completely different. They're not sleeping in the morning. They're not, running out of energy at 3 o'clock in the afternoon. So I think it's a pretty important step in the total package of living the good life. It's not just about outing, you know, tyrants. It's not just about finding political freedom. But there's a whole lot of other elements to leading a good life that involve feeling well and being well. And I think if more people do that, they'll find more happiness in their life.
Let's get into the documentary a little bit. The idea of it, how you came up with it, and basically the message behind it of what you think people should take from this, from watching the film.
Well, the show, the idea started off with Kat and I about 4 years ago, 3 years ago, came up with this concept of sovereign living. And originally it was supposed to be a spoof on Martha Stewart living. And it was just going to be Catherine leading the camera around, you know, dressed in a nice day dress and going to the gun range, doing canning and stuff. And along the way, we linked up with Kamikaze Productions, and they encouraged us to do it in a reality show format. And so that's how the show came to be a reality program. And we're just trying to show people another way. It's one thing to talk about another way, or to write essays about another way to live, or even to do a podcast about another way to live. But we wanted to demonstrate through video, through documenting our lives, that there is another way that we see as a better way to live. It's not for everybody, and that's okay too. But we genuinely think if people explore these different alternatives, if they live their life in a manner that's not dependent on centralized or coercive institutions, which is how we define sovereign living, not only will they find more freedom, but they'll find more happiness. I honestly think that's the way, that's the path that we ought to be going on in order to build the free society that we all yearn for. It's not enough just to lobby the council or to, you know, so many people knock on their neighbor's doors asking him to vote for Joe Schmo. We need to be knocking on our neighbor's doors, encouraging him to come start a community garden down the road, or just knock on their door and invite him to a potluck, you know? Nobody talks to each other unless it's political season, or even then nobody really talks to each other. So we're just trying to show people there's another way to live. And, you know, we don't claim to have all the answers in the program. We present the information in a very humble fashion. We just started gardening about 3 or 4 years ago. We don't know everything. We try to visit with experts to learn from them. We make a whole lot of mistakes. So that's another, I think, good value that we present in the show, is that anyone can do this. You don't have to be an expert. You can just dive right in, get your feet wet, and learn from your mistakes.
What would be the advice for people who might want to start getting involved with people living, you know, living off the grid, being more sustainable in their own way? Where would you start? Because people seem, may be a huge step, you know, think it's a huge transformation. What would you recommend for people just to kind of start off with, depending on their situation? I mean, anything, any advice you'd like to add?
Yeah, I'd say start small. Start small, you know, set up a container garden in your backyard with 5 or 6 pots, start growing tomatoes. I think a lot of people think it's easier to grow food than it really is. There's like survival seed banks and stuff, and people think they could just keep their seeds in the closet when crap hits the fan, pull the seeds out and plant them, and we'll be able to feed ourselves. There's a huge learning curve to actually going from seed to fruit, to food that you can eat. So I would recommend people just start by growing some tomatoes on their back porch. You know, even if you live in an apartment, you can have tomatoes on your porch. Another thing I would recommend is getting involved with the local food economy. So you don't even have to necessarily be the one to grow the food, although I think it's important to at least have a base understanding of how to grow food should you need to. Go find a community-supported agriculture program where you could chip in a small amount every month and get a share of the vegetables that are grown. Go to the farmer's market and buy locally sourced organic food. Those are some small steps when it comes to growing your own food. Food storage is always important. It's good to have 2 to 3 months of food storage. Hopefully you live in a state that actually allows private firearm ownership and the transfer of firearms. If you do and you don't own a firearm, I would purchase a firearm as soon as you can, even if it's a $200 rifle. I'd start with a shotgun actually before a rifle as far as home defense goes. Get yourself a handgun. I recommend a Glock 19. That's like a $600 or $700 pistol. You could get a nice, decent pistol for $200. Learn how to shoot proficiently. Try to set up alternative means of communication should the central grid go down. You want to link up with your friends and family through shortwave radio or CB radio, marine band radio. So I think there's a whole, just start small, really. Begin researching. Try to grow your own food. Learn from other people that are already doing it. Try to surround yourself with people that are a little more advanced when it comes to self-sufficiency, and then just mock what they do and what works for them.
Just to wrap it up here, where can people find more of the work, including more information about the documentary? How can they support you and your family on this journey there? And anything else you'd like to add?
Yeah, people can check out the daily news service at thelibertybeat.com. It's growing by leaps and bounds. We're about to expand into new markets. So that's thelibertybeat.com. they can watch episode one of the reality show. So far we have 4 episodes completed. Episode one is available for public viewing at sovereignliving.tv. If people want to purchase episodes 1 through 3, there's a DVD available there at that same website. So I would recommend people start with that, check that stuff out. I just started a weekly podcast all about Bitcoin. It's called Sovereign BTC. It's your guide to the practical side of everyday Bitcoin use. And the website for that is sovereignbtc.com. Catherine also started a weekly, it's not weekly, but it's a regular podcast, and that's called The BitMom, thebitmom.com, which also has educational information about unschooling and family entrepreneurship. So we got a lot of projects, we got a lot of irons in the fire, so recommend people check out those websites to learn more about what we're doing.
We are the Occupy Bus Tour, and we are a group of activists traveling around the country. We are supporting and reporting on actions. And we are labeling
because it's the right thing to do, and you know, fuck the pharmaceutical companies and fuck the government, and this is how we're helping people who are in our community, and we will overgrow them eventually.